Ladies and gentlemen, I don't want to spend too much time talking for this. Well, for the intro, that is. Because what I want to do here is I want to do a full speedrun of Metroid Dread. My main aim is to get it. My main goal is to have it under 4 hours. That's right. A Metroid Dread speedrun in under 4 hours. Fingers crossed I can pull it off. The fastest time I managed to do it was 4.5. Come on, I wish I can skip this intro. Everyone knows the lore for the Metroid Dread whole thing now, at this point. Because it started with Metroid, then we went to... What was it? First it was Metroid, then it moved over to Metroid 2, The Return of Samus on the Game Boy. Then it went to Super Metroid on the SNES. Then you went to Metroid Fusion on the Game Boy Advance, and now, finally, here, Metroid Dread. Yeah, Metroid Dread for Nintendo Switch. So, fingers crossed, I can pull this speedrun off. Because, like I said, my main goal is to have it under 4 hours. Let's go. If it'll finish loading, that is. I don't plan on stopping at any, like, potential save points except for the map download stations and also the terminal broadcast stations where I can talk to Adam. Where is he? Up above? Okay. So go here. First main Emmy down. Oh boy. And from this I get, what is it again? The spider magnet. Oh, I know where I'm at now. Yes. Yes. Too easy. Thank you. Oh. Yes. Random cloak. Wow, that's all within 30 minutes. Come on. Not that long. I got the morph ball now. Okay. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Made it. Okay. Yeah, I made it, but not without a few mishaps. Give me that. Barrier suit. So now I can withstand the hot temperatures, but unfortunately I can't withstand the cold temperatures or moving around in lava without the gravity suit. Okay, let's try this again. Okay. Ah. I was out of missiles. I ran out. Alright. I did that too early. Okay, okay. Yes. So I need to find a straightaway fast. Come on, come on, come on. There we go. I like to point out the fact that out of all the times that I have unfortunately died, not one of them was from an Emmy capture. That's what I like most about this speedrun. Speed booster, shine. Yeah, and use the speed booster to activate Shine Spark. See? Ready to find Spark. Okay. We're good. By the way, since I skipped the cutscene, that Chozo that's laying dead on the ground, that was a friendly Chozo for Samus, and he deactivated the Emmys for us, so we can move around the areas at the moment without worrying about them. See? Wait, oh, I know what's going on. This thing. there's half the water. Done. Okay, third time's the charm. Okay. Oh no, wait. I'll let y'all have one cutscene, and this will be it. Parasite. The ex-parasite revive. Well, technically, it's. Yeah. So the ex-parasite possessed the dead corpse of our Doha Chozo friend, and now the Emmys are back online. Which way is he coming from? Bottom. On. Okay. The moment his plate came off, he just sped up. Oh boy. And then this Emmy is the one that's supposed to give me the ice missile. Yep. So now I can get rid of. Now I can get rid of those frickin' fiery plants. Storm Missile. Here we go. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Give me that. The gravity suit. Now I can move freely through liquid environment. Finally. Okay. Try this again. I don't think I'd be able to comprehend a full sentence right now. Or speak a full sentence, I don't know. Oh yeah, okay. Let's try this again, buddy. Yeah, nice try. Cross bomb. Okay, I'm in the area that I need to be. Finally. There we go. Whew. Okay. The thing is though, with the purple Emmy, to get it in the one spot that I need to is the hardest. Simply like that. Charge. Bam. Easy does it. Oh boy. And the recording for this has just gone past 4 hours and 10 minutes. Oh, finally, I got the wave beam. But we're in the final Emmy zone. And this Emmy right here just got fried because of Samus's her Metroid DNA was accelerating. Power bomb. Finally. That was the last ability I needed before I can take on Ravenbeak. Last of the missiles. Thank you. Cutscene would have initiated to the final phase of the fight, where Samus transforms into her Metroid suit. I'm just skipping it because it's already 4.5 hour long recording and I am tired. This speedrun, was it worth it? Maybe. I just want to see if I had gotten it, if the game time's gonna be 4 hours or less. Oy vey. Come on. Come on. Back to here. Bada bing, bada boom. Up we go, up we go, up, 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 up. Made it. Okay. Now, the moment of truth. What's the clear time for the game? What's the clear time? That's a new record. My God. Look, okay. Keep in mind, this was on hard mode. Clear time altogether is 3 hours and 51 minutes, 9 seconds. Total play time, if you include cutscenes and everything, 5 hours, 17 minutes, 26 seconds. Item collection, 36%, I don't care. Energy, 799, 123 missiles, 2 power bombs, 34 times I died. Total damage received, 38,000. Bosses defeated, 30. Time saved, 27. Oh. Oh. All the artwork for that. Okay, I'm making my webcam disappear. Hold up. Look at that! That is sick! Wow! I gotta show this. So we have artwork from Metroid Dread, artwork from Metroid Fusion, Metroid Other M, there's Samus Returns, and then Metroid Zero Mission. If you look here, I have 5 out of 6 pieces of artwork unlocked. That is because you need to clear the game within a certain time frame for the specific artwork. So, for artworks number 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, 1, 2, and 3. You would have to do that on normal difficulty, while 4, 5, and 6 are on hard difficulty. So for artworks 1 and 4, you have to clear either normal or hard difficulty before 12 hours. Artworks 2 and 5, you have to finish either of the difficulties within 8 hours. And for artworks 3 and 6, you have to finish it in under 4 hours. Ladies and gentlemen, that was a 3 hour and 51 minute speedrun of Metroid Dread. I don't think I've ever finished a game that fast before. Oh my god.